Long time no see. So I am at Folkestone today, which is the home of the Channel Tunnel train thing, but more importantly, it is a Cretaceous locality where you get some pretty nice fossils. I've never been here before, so I don't know exactly what I'm doing or exactly what I'm looking for. The goal today is some sort of iridescent ammonite from the Gault Clay. That is what I would like. Don't know whether I'm going to find it. I'm not sure whether I'm in it particularly the right spot. There is a lot of clay coming out of the cliffs, but as we all know, you shouldn't go right up to the cliffs. So I'm currently looking around the foreshore, seeing if I can find anything in between these massive boulders, especially while I am, well, I've got the tide where I want it, which is not here. So yeah, I'll bring you along for the trip and hopefully we'll find something cool. Currently sat on a boulder filled with a bunch of trace fossils, a bunch of burrows, because we know that's the thing I love. But so far, nothing else yet. Hopefully my luck will change as we go further along the beach. So let's go. This is very typical of what you'll see in this area, in the Gault Clay. You get these like really nice impressions of ammonites. I mean, these are the actual ammonites. So this iridescence you see here is the actual shell that has been preserved. The nacre, not sure how you pronounce it, but that's what it looks like as a word. And these ammonites are really fragile. I mean, you can see I'm just pulling apart this rock with my hand. Oh, that's nice. Really easily. So these were really difficult to collect because they just break away into nothing. I'm not going to try to collect this one because it will just fall to pieces, and if I got it in my bag in one nice piece, then inevitably across the journey home it would not survive particularly well. But they are lovely to look at and get pictures of and appreciate, which is that's what we're here to do. It's a nice little gastropod there, actually.
Which one's gastropod?
I've just spotted, like a little tiny one. So yeah, in this block we've got ammonites, we've got gastropods, we've got bivalves and all these mussels and things. Sometimes you'll get a more solid bit of ammonite and you'll get something that looks a bit more like this, which is still nice and shiny and has the original shell, but this probably would actually survive the journey home, so I might take this home as a nice memento of this area of the beach. So,
oh no.
So I said that these are very, very difficult to get out in one piece, and Alex had a go. How did it go, Alex?
I thought it was going really well, to be honest, and then it split in half. And then it turned out this is only half of it.
No, that's the whole thing.
Oh really? What's this?
Yeah. See, this is all the shot. Really? That's lovely, look at that.
I know.
Oh my gosh.
This plate up in there.
Please focus, I'm begging you, that's so pretty. So there's a nice ammonite here, but we're not going to collect it because it's preserved in this clay, which means it is really, really fragile, and it's more trouble than it's worth to collect, frankly. Yeah, but it looks cool.
Are you happy with me taking a hammer to this this ammonite in clay?
Sure, I wouldn't go for happy. I'm not sure that's the word I would use, but also it will get destroyed next time the sea comes in.
Oh, will it?
Yeah. Yeah, these things are really, really fragile. I mean, like, look at that.
So if we hadn't been here today...
Yeah, no one would have ever seen it.
Oh, I've cracked it already. Hey, here's a little bit of ammonite.
It's beautiful.
Frankly, being not worth getting out, someone who was bored with a pointy thing had to go anyway.
How do you intend on getting it home in one piece?
Giving it to you to deal with. There you go. Now if you move, you'll break it.
Oh shoot! Came out in one go. More or less. Don't really know what you want to do with it now.
Keep it! Put it in a kiln.
In a kiln? I wonder if that would work.
I mean, it would, right? Fire it.